The use of deadly force to protect his patrol cars?
Video obtained exclusively by News Channel 5 Investigates is raising new questions about a deadly shooting last year.
Investigative reporter Ben Hall has the body cam tapes that caught the sheriff's shocking admissions.
White County Sheriff Odie Shoup did not realize he was being recorded right after officers shot and killed a man. A deputy was holding a body camera. Neither knew was on. They put the camera in the back of a patrol car, and what it caught the sheriff saying raises new questions about what happened following a two-county police chase and is at the center of a federal lawsuit. The slow-speed chase started hours earlier in neighboring DeKalb County. Last April, Smithville police attempted to pull over Michael Dial for driving on a suspended license. He was driving a 1976 pickup, towing a fully loaded trailer.
Why didn't stop? He was scared. I know him enough to know that.
Robin Dial can't believe how things escalated and that her husband is gone.
When I wake up every day and he's not there, it's like going through it all over again.
The chase never reached high speeds. DeKalb County deputies later told the TBI it was more like a funeral procession.
How fast do you think you got up to?
We might have got up to 50 at one point. For the most part, it was somewhere between 30 and 40 miles an hour.
DeKalb deputies backed off at the county line, and White County took over. Their deputies tried to stop Dial using their patrol car.
73 is out of service, 1708.
Reserve Deputy Adam West got involved driving his personal pickup.
We're on edge too.
Sheriff Odie Shoup was not involved in the chase, but he gave orders to the radio dispatcher authorizing deputies to shoot Dial.
459, take him out by any means necessary, including deadly force.
After that order, you see Deputy West take out his gun. They're on Highway 111 with few cars in sight. Minutes later, deputies push Dial's truck off the road. West gets out of his truck and immediately opens fire. Officer Charlie Sims also started shooting. Dial was struck in the head. He was unarmed.
I feel with every part of me that that's exactly what they wanted to do was kill him.
But Dial's lawsuit focuses on what the sheriff said after the shooting to another deputy on that body camera they didn't know was on.
I told him, I said, take him out.
I heard.
Damn, I don't give a
shit. It wasn't long after that. I heard shots fired.
I said, we'll ram him. I said, don't ram him, shoot him.
Dial is suing White County, the sheriff, Deputy West, and Sparta Officer Sims, claiming they used excessive force. The lawsuit claims Shoup preferred to shoot and kill Mr. Dial rather than risk damaging his patrol cars.
I ain't gonna turn my cars up. They don't think I'll give a damn order to kill that mother. They full of shit. Take him out. I'm here on the damn end, wrong end of the damn county.
Shoup seemed upset he wasn't there when the shooting happened.
I love his God, I tell you what, I thrive on it.
I don't know how you can thrive on taking a human life. That's not law enforcement.
Attorney David Weissman said there was no reason to shoot Mr. Dial, and Shoup's comments prove he was more concerned with his cars than Dial's life.
If that's the mentality from the highest policymaker in the town, in the county, that's scary.
A seat caller, please.
The TBI and district attorney ruled the shooting justified, but immediately afterward, Deputy West was clearly upset. Sheriff Shoup told him he did exactly as he was ordered.
You don't have to worry about this. I made the decision. You don't have to worry about it. I took that away from y'all. You don't have to worry about nothing. Everything's cool. You done just exactly right.
He wouldn't hurt anybody.
Robin Dial will never believe her husband needed to die.
They could have let him 10 more miles down the road, he probably would have run out of gas. I just hope he knows I loved him.
Shots fired! Shots fired!
The DA is standing by his ruling the shooting was justified, but admits he had not heard the sheriff's comments when he made that ruling. The sheriff has declined to comment.
They gonna turn my cars up. They don't think I'll give a damn water to kill that mother. They full of shit. Take him out. I'm here on the damn end, wrong in the damn county.
Shoup seemed upset he wasn't there when the shooting happened.
I love his shit. God, I tell you what, I thrive on it.
I don't know how you can.
Police officer off the job after he threatened to kill a man for driving the wrong way. This was an ugly confrontation after a traffic stop, and it's not the first time this detective has been caught on camera. Let's get right to Jim Smith with the story. He's working at Live in Medford tonight. Jim.
Lisa, this driver says he was very frightened. He says this off-duty detective went way overboard, and tonight other people are speaking out too, saying that they have also had run-ins with this guy. In the dark of night, a man driving a pickup truck gets out and aggressively approaches another driver. That driver throws it in reverse, but the guy keeps coming and makes a threat.
Oh, I didn't know you were a cop.
Right through your head.
I didn't know you were a cop.
I'll put a hole right through your head.
Okay.
That's right. It was an off-duty Medford police detective named Stephen LeBert. He accused the driver of making a wrong turn at a rotary.
You're lucky I'm a cop, because I've been beating the f*** out of you right now.
Jeez.
Give me a license.
I just want to let you
give
know.
Give me a license.
I also want to let you know.
Give me a license.
Okay, I just want to let you know. I also have a dash camera.
No, he's digging for his gun, telling me he's going to shoot me. And I'm like, it's a bit extreme, don't you think? It was definitely nerve-wracking when someone is like, hey, I'm going to shoot you. And no one really can prepare for that.
LeBert has now been placed on leave.
Based on what I saw, I'm troubled. What I saw and what I heard, I am troubled.
This isn't LeBert's first video moment. 3 years ago, he had to undergo counseling after making moves on a camera operated by a drug suspect's brother, saying this about that suspect.
What you should do is just take him up on the railroad tracks and tell him to lay down.
And now another person has come forward to WBZ, saying she had a run-in with LeBert when he accused her of parking too close to his cruiser.
After I went out into the parking lot, he started screaming at me, called me an ignoramus, just was out of control over just a situation where he had couldn't get into his cruiser because he wasn't parked properly.
Detective LeBert is a 30-year veteran of the Medford Police Department. Tonight, he is on paid leave pending an internal review. Live at Medford PD headquarters, Jim Smith, WBZ News. David?
Jim, thank you.
NYPD officers in Queens got arrested, accused of being corrupt. The FBI says those cops were involved in several schemes, including taking cash payoffs from a towing firm to get first dibs on tows at accident scenes. Chief Investigative Reporter Jonathan Dientz broke news of the arrest this morning, and he joins us now with more. John?
Adam, one of the cops is allegedly on tape boasting he was by far the worst cop in the 105th precinct in Queens. Prosecutors say he not only helped orchestrate the corrupt towing scheme, but after retiring, he offered to help a drug gang. And they say he boasted of racist conduct on and off the job. Three NYPD cops allegedly took thousands in cash payoffs to give business to one towing company. In over 100 accidents in Queens, the FBI says the three officers called that one towing company, illegally looking up accident victim information to pass on through the towing firm to give to a law firm for possible accident-related lawsuits. U.S. Attorney Mark Lesko says the three officers shamelessly violated their oaths of office and the public trust
by trading their badges for cash payments. The three officers allegedly ran the scheme from 2016 out of the 105th Precinct. The FBI arrested the three at their Long Island homes this morning. Robert Smith, the alleged ringleader, found in Plainview. Robert Hassett, arrested near Farmingville, and Heather Bush in Massapequa. Prosecutors say Smith, who retired in 2020, is also on tape offering to deliver heroin for a drug gang. And they say Smith was recorded bragging about uncharged crimes in the years he worked in the 105. And after he retired, at times using racist language. Bro, I robbed everyone. Bro, I point my gun out the window at and watch their reaction and drive away. Now the real Smith will shine. I even shaved my head. Klan. Smith pleaded not guilty in Brooklyn federal court and was ordered held without bail. NYPD Commissioner Shea immediately suspended current officers Bush and Hassett without pay, saying there's zero tolerance for this alleged corruption. As part of the towing scheme, the officers allegedly picked up thousands in cash in a set mailbox. With Smith retiring, he allegedly recruited Officer Bush to step in and take his place. Officers Hassett and Bush were being arrested.
Let me put the hay where the sheep can reach it. What do you think could unite the masses to turn against you? No, man, you. What do you think could unite everybody? Not just left, right, black, white, green, yellow. What do you think could unite the masses to turn against you? And let me say a few words of wisdom to you about what we just watched. Those are dangerous people. They're all white. Okay? This notion that every white person is my brother is just horseshit. And I get so tired of the ignorant people that want to keep saying that. It's just so ignorant and so very foolish, man. That's not the way it works from God. Either you have God's spirit or you don't have God's spirit, okay? Those people do not have God's spirit. They're evil. They're born evil. We've talked about it in our ministry many times. There's videos you can watch where I give you the facts from God. Some people are born evil. They don't change. They're not of God. Now, watching that hurt you, it angered you, pissed you off. I understand it. Really, I do. These are dangerous, crazy people. And the reason I did one from up north, the one south, just to show you, I mean, this is all over the country. I mean, this is everywhere. I mean, it can be Massachusetts, it can be Georgia, it can be Oregon, it can be Texas, it can be the Dakotas. It does not matter. It doesn't matter. Law enforcement in this country right now are tools of the Babylonian beast system. And it doesn't matter their age. People say, "What's well, it's the young cops coming up now." That's a lie, too. The guy you've seen in the video, the one in the South, man, he was 50, 60 years old. He's been evil all his life. He wants to hurt. But he would never want to fight somebody fairly, you see. Never. It's not in them. They want to hurt innocent animals. They want to hurt innocent people. But they would never take a guy like me and say, let's walk to the top of a mountain. One of us is going to stop breathing. God's going to watch. They wouldn't go because they wouldn't make it back down. What's the difference and what's really going on with this whole law enforcement agenda? First of all, why do we even have law? See, what we're supposed to have is God's law. We don't need law. God's children do not have law. You see, the law that we have today, the policeman, is not for you and I. He was made for the other people, and it was not made by us. Those who are of God don't need to be policed by anybody, okay? They don't need to be policed by anybody. God does it fine, all right? We follow Jesus Christ. We don't need special people dressed up. Okay, with guns and sticks. We don't need that. The world does. The world needs that. And there are times when cops are good. Cops help certain people. All right, this is a fact. However, we live in a country right now where the agenda is, all we're told is that cops are anti-black, cops are anti-black, cops are anti-black. That's a lie, man. Most cops are anti-everybody. Now, they may have some bias in certain parts of the country toward black people. But many of the cops that you see, they're evil. And they hate. And it ain't got a damn thing to do with the color of your skin. They hate. They don't have a spirit of God in them. They do not have the spirit of God in them. Romans 8:14 says, "For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God." to be led by the Spirit of God, do you think the monsters, the animals that we just looked at, do you think they have a Spirit of God in them? Not hardly. 1 John chapter 3:1 says, "Behold, what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. Therefore the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not." 1 John 4:13 says, "Hereby know we that we dwell in him, and he in us, because he hath given us of his Spirit." Again, the Spirit of God. If you have to encounter any kind of law enforcement, you do it with wisdom. You do it with Jesus Christ. If you're being pulled over, you call out to your Father and pray. When the patrolman or whoever is comes up to your car, be polite. Use wisdom. Pray to your Father. Use Jesus Christ. Use it. If they come to your door, it's the same thing. You got to use wisdom. All right? There's no need to act a fool. There's no need to go a certain way unless it has to go a certain way. I believe these animals are going to get worse. And do I call all of them animals? No, I don't know them all. But I do know that cops walk around and they are some of, just let me be honest, I know some people defend cops. They say, well, cops got a hard job, blah, blah, blah. I'm not even sure if they even have a hard job. I hear this all the time. What do you mean they have a hard job? Hard job how? What's their hard job? And some people say, well, they have to go into this type of neighborhood. That's hard. Is it really that hard? Huh. All right, well, let me just close by saying this, man. I showed you those videos for a reason. We've never talked about cops before in our ministry. You're going to see a lot more of them in the end, because they're going to be moved to do more and more evil. As the snake tries to squeeze and they try to divide and then unite people, cops will play a role in it. They will play a role in it. And we have to do what we always do. We have to be led by our Spirit. We have to pray. We have to do right by our Father. We got to talk to our Father. And we have to use our Spirit, and we have to use the name of Jesus Christ in everything that we are doing. I've had quite a few encounters with cops, bad ones. Guns to the head, taken off, man. It's some bad stuff, man. I never got along too well with them. I'm sure there's some decent ones. I've met a couple decent ones. For the most part, I wouldn't want to be around them because I don't trust them. I don't trust anybody that works for the Babylonian beast system. All right, there's a reason why they are a cop. Listen, exercise wisdom. Never say more than you have to. Never say more than you have to. All right? Exercise wisdom. And most importantly, man, most importantly, Jesus. Jesus. Jesus Christ. If you got to rebuke that monster in the name of Jesus, you do it. And you damn sure, you better mean it. You better believe it. It's got to be everything of who you are. You know that old man in that video, the one who shot the guy, who had the guy shot? You know, you look at a guy like that, and he could appear to many people as a grandpa type, or he could show up at a luncheon or a function or a school, and he'd be like this guy that, hey, everybody likes. Behind closed doors, he's a sick, sadistic monster, man. Or how about the guy up in Massachusetts? This guy's dangerous. He was a cop for 20 years. You see, these people are everywhere, man. This is the world that we are living in. And it's not just America. It's Europe, Scandinavia. It's everywhere. They are a part of the beast system. You use wisdom, good sound judgment, and most importantly, Jesus Christ. God is the one.